Hey everyone, welcome back. The modern bikes of today are requiring not only different rear spacing for their hubs, but also different chain lines. As you probably know, SRAM is dealing with it in part by giving us different offset chain rings and also a wide version of their cranks. But what about Shimano? How are the current 12-speed drivetrains dealing with this? Let's check it out. And the reality is, Shimano with their 12-speed drivetrains, they finally introduced direct mount chainrings. However, all the chainrings are the same, and the difference is in the cranksets. And you see the three models of the SLX here, the 7100, 7120, and 7130. Interestingly, you're not going to see 49mm chain line here anymore. 49mm was for non-boosted frames. But what they say is that 7100 is for 52mm, so that's a boosted 148mm frame. Q factor is 172, and this should be used with the old 142 and 135mm rear spacing as well. This is still for boost 7120. However, this provides you with a 55mm chain line for bikes like my Yeti that need more tire clearance, so they have to go wider here at the spindle. Finally, Super Boost Plus or 157mm, that's where you're gonna need the 7130. That gives us a 56.5mm chain line and 181mm Q factor. So again, boost and non-boost, boost with wider tire clearance, and super boost or 157mm hub spacing. They recommend using the same bottom bracket for all these cranks. For threaded BBs, both 68 and 73mm BB shells. As for press fit, it's the same MT800-PA press fit, both 89.5 and 92mm BB shells. Chainring is not mentioned anywhere in here because for SLX XT and XTR, it doesn't come with one automatically, but you can obviously order some of the chainrings that Shimano makes for their cranks. They're direct mounted. XT and SLX chainrings are identical, or order some third-party chainrings like this oval. More and more manufacturers like Wolftooth have chainrings for these new Shimano cranks, and that's great news because they can offer ovals, lower weight, and maybe more offset options in the future. And talking about Shimano chainrings, they are all looking kind of the same as this, with a few variations. Obviously, the tooth profile is the DCE Plus, so dynamic chain engagement. That's their version of the narrow wide tooth profiles. And with all these chainrings having the same offset, the difference must be in the spindle length that they provide their cranks with, which also means that the non-drive sides or the left side crank arms should be identical between these three models. This is a 7100 for 52mm chain line, which is really tight on this frame, by the way. But if we look here on the non-drive side crank arm, you're gonna see 7100, but right underneath 7120, 7130, confirming my assumption. In the box, I have this 7120 for 55mm chain line. And yeah, they provide a user manual, but if we look at this non-drive side, 7100 is what it says on the crank arm, but 7120, 7130 are mentioned in there as well, just like we saw it on the other crank arm. Also in the box, you're gonna get this Shimano TLFC41. This is needed to install and remove the new chain rings. So yeah, it's another tool. And you're also gonna get these, the preload adjuster nut for your non-dry side crank. You're gonna get this lock ring for your new direct mount chain rings. And finally, you're gonna get 2 3mm spacers. I'm gonna be installing this absolute black oval on my cranks. And from the lock ring, you're gonna see that this is for SLX and XT only. And you need to tighten it to 35 to 50 Newton meters. Obviously, you're gonna need the tool that I just mentioned to accomplish that. This tool, actually the whole direct mount idea is new for Shimano. Remember, the Q factor difference between 7100 and 7120 is 6 millimeter, 172 versus 178, and the chain line difference is 3 millimeter, 52 versus 55. The Q factor means the distance between the outside of each crank arm, so where your pedals get connected. And this spindle should be longer or shorter by 6 millimeters compared to my 7120. And measuring it, the 7100 spindle comes up to 115 millimeters long, and 7120 comes up to 121 millimeters long. So 6 millimeters difference. Hence, the two spacers that they provided with this crankset, each 3 millimeters that have to be installed on both sides of my bottom bracket. Aside from installing one of these spacers on each side of the bottom bracket, and by the way, there is a rubbery face to it, make sure you put it against the bottom bracket. So aside from that, the installation of these crank arms is quite simple, and I have it documented. I'll make sure to link it. But you can see how the 55 millimeter chain line versus 52 gives me a lot more room here on my bike. You can see how I can install the oval now, whereas before I couldn't even dream about it. So that's the 3 millimeter spacer that's now installed right there on the drive side, but that's only possible because the spindle of this cranks is longer by 6 millimeters. If you're wondering how extreme is the 55 millimeter chain line on a 12 speed drivetrain from Shimano, I'm not dropping the chain from the largest cog, the 51. It is extreme indeed, as you can see it here, but I guess it would be usable. This is how that chain line looks like from this other side. Obviously not less extreme. This bike has a 433 millimeter chainstay. If your bike has even shorter chainstays, 55 millimeter chain line might be a bit too much. Chain is on a straight line from the chainring to the cassette, right here on the fifth cog from the smallest. So I guess if you were to use 2/3, 75% of the cassette right here, nothing's too extreme, that chain line gets more extreme, obviously, when you make it to the 51 tooth. This wouldn't be any different than what Shimano recommends for their non-boosted frames, which is the use of these 7100, which is a 52 millimeter chain line. So I just hope that Shimano tested the heck out of it and it works okay long term. Are you guys finding this information useful? Because if you do, I could use your help. A simple like or subscribe helps my channel quite a bit. Thanks in advance. But back to our chain line discussion, you can see how Shimano is using different spindle lengths for all these standards. For Super Boost, they have a longer spindle and just 4.5 millimeter spacers instead of 3. That's how they address the needs for more gears, more tire clearance, and better bracing angles on our wheels, that being given by Boost or Super Boost these days. We did use SLX cranks for our discussion today, but if you were to look at the 12-speed offering from Shimano today, the principles we discussed about chain line and Q factor apply for their entire line from Dior to XTR. Are you folks using 52 millimeter chain line for your non-boosted frames? What about boosted frames? Do you use 55 millimeter chain line or the 52 given to me by this 7100? I would love to hear your opinion. As usual, don't forget to comment in the section below. And until next time, hope to see you folks on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.